Hi, Dr. Walter Salubro here again. Welcome to another video. And I want to bring your attention now to the nervous system. Let's look at the nervous system more closely. This is one of the segments in my report that when I teach my patients, they get tremendous, tremendous value out of it because they just don't get this information in other doctor's offices. They do in chiropractic offices, but usually not in other doctor's offices like physicians or medical doctors. They just don't teach this. But when patients get this from a visual perspective, they finally understand how their spine and misalignments of their spine is related to their health problems or their symptoms. And now, when you know where the problem is and you're given an opportunity to correct it, then a lot of healing can actually begin to happen for that person. Okay, so this is very, very important, valuable information. So let's take a look at this. Over here I have a chart of the nervous system. Now, I want you to get the overall big picture of this. This is just showing one aspect of the nervous system, which is called the autonomic nervous system, which controls all your automatic functions like your heartbeat, your lungs breathing, your digestive system, things that happen without you consciously thinking about it, okay? But just get the big picture of how the nervous system works and how these nerves travel throughout your body and to see how important the nervous system is. So the nervous system is the one master control system of the entire body. There's nothing in your body, organs, tissue, cells, body parts, that is not controlled by the nervous system. It's just that simple. Any doctor or any person can open up any anatomy book and will see that the one system that controls every other system is the nervous system. And of course, everyone gets that when we talk about the brain, right? So especially when there's such thing as, you know, people that suffer brain damage. They suffer brain damage, well, they're not going to function very well. They're going to be debilitated. They can't move. They're not going to talk. They may need life support, may need feeding tubes. That's not a normal way to function. Why? Because if there's damage to the brain, then the rest of the body will not function well, okay, or will not repair well, will not heal well. So when we look at the brain, right, everything starts up here. The brain is that one organ that controls everything. But the information that the brain can do, the power of the brain, doesn't just sit there. It gets transmitted through your whole body. And it needs a wiring system or a communication system to connect to all your body parts. And that's where the spinal cord and the spinal nerves come into play. So the brain will be here, essentially stems down will be here into the brain stem. Okay, that's why it's called the brain stem. It's essentially a stem of the brain. And that's very, very close to the top of the neck, okay? So it approximates the top of the neck. It's a very important area that chiropractors look at. Very common area of misalignments or subluxations, cause a lot of issues, a lot of health problems just in this one area here. So it continues on. As you see this white cord over here, this white structure, that is the spinal cord that sits within the spinal column. Okay? So the strong bones of the spine, they protect what's on the inside, which is the spinal cord, which is an extension of the brainstem and the brain. Okay, follow so far? And of course, the spinal cord is going to go all the way inside the spine over here, ends right about here, continues on to spinal nerves. But what it does is, it doesn't just sit there, it needs to connect to all your body parts. And it branches out into these nerves. So between here and here, there's 31 pairs of nerves, they're called spinal nerves, that connect to all your organ systems. They connect everywhere, okay? Now, this is the part that most of my patients find really interesting because they, when they hear this segment of my report, they say, oh, well, that's why I have a headache, or maybe that's why my digestive system, I'm not digesting my food well, or I get heartburn, or I'm constipated, or maybe this is why I have menstrual cramps and, you know, very serious PMS symptoms, or maybe this is why, you know, my back is hurting and there's pain shooting down my leg. It begins to give them a pictorial view of what's causing their symptoms, and again, when you have the picture of what's causing the problem, and we know what that is, we now can plan to correct for it, okay? So, this is so neat. The nerves of the upper neck here, near the brainstem, they're going to branch out to essentially the area of the head and the face, okay? So, the head and the face. So, they'll branch out, they'll go to the head area, they'll go to the face structures, eyes, ears, nose, throat, those kind of things, sinuses. So, if there's a subluxation in this upper area here, it will cause interference with the normal function of those body parts and can lead to things like headaches, dizziness, blurred vision, ringing in the ears, sinus issues, perhaps even ear problems, anything related to the head and face function. Okay, these nerves here, because they come from the brainstem area, okay, up here, they all, if you follow the green nerves, they also go to other organs such as the heart, the lungs, the stomach, the liver, all the way down to the large bowel, the large intestines, okay? So there's a major connection of the upper neck over here near the upper part of the spine and the brainstem to your visceral organs. Super, super important information, okay? The nerves of the lower neck will be here. They'll go towards the lower neck muscles, the shoulders, into the arms, into the fingers, okay? And a lot of people have arm pain, numbness, tingling. It gets missed. You know, people will look in the elbow and the wrist, but they won't look at the neck area, okay? So subluxations in the neck area can cause problems in the arms, okay? The nerves of the mid-back, well, they'll obviously go to the chest area and the back area, but they branch directly to the heart, the lungs, the stomach, okay? So those very important organ systems. And the nerves of the low back will be here. Well, a lot of people understand that those nerves will affect the low back area, but those nerves also branch to down the back of the leg, and that's when it causes leg pain, such as sciatic type pain or sciatica, anything related to leg pain. It goes right down to the bottom of the foot. But these same nerves, they also go down to the lower pelvic, the pelvic organs, the lower digestive organs, so yeah, the sex glands, the sex organs, uterus, prostate gland, and the large intestines as well. So those organs there, okay? So you can see there's a direct link, a direct connection with all your body parts to the spinal cord, which means there's a direct link to all your body parts to the brain. And what's that one structure that's gonna protect your spinal cord? That's the spinal column. That's why it's super important that the spinal bones from the front need to be optimally aligned straight from the front, and from the side have these three natural curves, because when it's in its optimal position, it's protecting the spinal cord very, very well, which means now there's an open connection between the brain and the rest of your body parts, and now that means your body is able to function, heal, and repair optimally the way it is designed to do.